A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 29th December, Sunday, on the front page you have no extra charge on payments via RuPay UPI from January 1. So digital transactions made using RuPay credit cards or UPI QR codes will not attract additional charges for merchants or customers from next year onwards. This is what Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has announced. So all shops, business establishments, companies with annual turnover of 50 crore or more have been mandated to offer these modes of payment to customers for free, with no extra charge. Then this is arrest of septuagenarians leaves family distraught. So this is regarding people in 70s. Septuagenarians means people in the age 70 years of age, in the 70s in as such. So they have been arrested in UP with charges of rioting. And this was despite they were under house arrest. Then below you have Delhi shivers as temperature plummets to 2.4 degrees Celsius. So severe cold wave conditions are likely in Delhi with temperatures as low as 2 degrees Celsius. And this is at least 90 people killed in Mogadishu blast. So this is in Mogadishu, the capital, which is the capital of Somalia. Somali in Africa. So here you can see at least 90 people were killed and dozens wounded when a bomb laden vehicle exploded at a bustling checkpoint in Mogadishu. So you can see it is one of the most deadly recent attacks. On page 9 you have Mahagenco's mining project in Raigarh put on ice. So this is regarding the mining project in Raigarh in Madhya Pradesh. So there are protests by villagers here against the coal mine project. And environmental panel of the central government has sent back the proposal to seek clearance to operate this coal mine. So here you can see an environmental panel of central government has flagged, means has raised concerns over incorrect details being put forth. So affected families also claim consent for coal mine operation was falsified. Means they have not given consent for the coal mine operation. On page 11, you have Muslims give rupees 6.27 lakh for damaged property. So this is a group of Muslims who have handed over a demand draft of 6.27 lakh to Bulandshahr District Administration to compensate for damages to public property during violent protests against the Citizenship Amendment Act in Uttar Pradesh in December 2019. So they requested police to withdraw cases filed against members of the community. So they have paid up for the damaged property. On international page, again, you have the same news continuing regarding Hong Kong protests, which are taking place, Taliban attacks in Afghanistan, and then the Trump impeachment process going on, and protests in Iraq as such, and also Iraq military base has been attacked by, rocket attack. And then here you have in Chile, in South America, here also protests are going on and people clash with the police. So these anti-government demonstrations which are going on in Chile also. This is regarding yesterday's news, Kazakhstan plane crash. So all this is continuation or in some way news which has already been covered. So now the black boxes of the aeroplane would be sent to Moscow for investigation to understand why the plane crashed. And this is regarding China. China has banned labor camp detentions for sex workers. So actually China's custody and education punishment system was there in which police was allowed to hold sex workers and their clients without charge for up to 2 years. So they would be in custody and educated. So now this 3-decade-old system will be ended. It is said sex workers are subjected to police violence, forced labor, compulsory testing for sexually transmitted diseases, humiliation as such. So this system will end now from December 29. And this is regarding China-US trade war too, in which now American books are being targeted by China. So there's near fees in regulatory approvals for books from US. On business page, you have FPI flows cross 1 lakh crore in 2019. So, year 2019 saw foreign portfolio investments. So, portfolio investments are in stocks, equity. So foreign portfolio investments are betting big on Indian equities, with total inflows breaching 1 lakh crore mark only for the first fourth time ever since 2013. So this is that. So this is short term money, like, it, you know, they can invest, they can take it out anytime. So it's highly volatile, foreign portfolio investment. FDI, FII or FDI is long term investment. It's investment in some company or something which would stay in the country, which can easily not run away overnight. Then here you have bank deposit cover set for increase. So here you can see this is Deposit Insurance and Credit Guarantee Corporation. It will increase the deposit insurance limit. So we have seen how presently the deposit insurance limit is quite low. So government has now proposed to increase this. So only deposits up to 1 lakh are insured by DIGCC. So this will be increased to between 3 lakh to 5 lakh now. So this is a recommendation of the RBI too. And DICGC is a subsidiary of RBI. So it has proposed to the government to increase this insurance limit. Then on Sundays, you have FAQ coverage, frequently asked questions, in which three important issues are covered. So the first one here is the economy in really bad shape? So we are seeing economic slowdown. So it is said, is this result of cyclical phenomena, means it will go down and then come up again on its own. So is it a cyclical phenomena, or had it been driven by structural malaise arising from deficiencies in the economic framework, or are there some concerns in the economy? So is it cyclical, or is there structural problems which is resulting in this downslide as such? So are there some deficiencies in the economic framework of the country? So that is tried to be understood here. So many a times government has claimed it is a cyclical phenomena, but then even if it is, structural reforms are required, that is always emphasized on. And now we'll have a budget coming in 2019-20. In 2020. So that will be 2021 budget. And this is protecting minors. So this is regarding the protests against Citizenship Amendment Act taking place, and detention of minors have been seen in some instances, means children below 18 years of age. So this says, what does law say about such detentions by police, and what role do commissions play, like National Human Rights Commission, etc. So this is covered here. So it has been seen that police has detained minors, at least 5 minors were detained by Uttar Pradesh police. They were in the age group of 13 to 17. Then below you have, what is the directive on detention centers? So this is again in the context of NPR, NRC concern. So those who are excluded from NPR and NRC have a number of apprehensions that how have states responded? So if a person is not finding his or her name in NRC, what happens? Is the understanding is that they would go to detention centers. So what are these detention centers, and how would this entire process work, and how did it happen in Assam is understood here. So in Assam also, we have seen around 19 lakh people were excluded from the final list. But then the government had stated that they would not directly go to detention centers. There would be cases against them and post that. You know, they would go to detention centers. But before that, when foreigners were detected, they would be sent to detention centers. Then cases would go on against them in foreigners tribunals, and they would continue to stay in detention centers. So this is the concern actually. So, and if they are not placed in detention centers, then they cannot be traced. So that's what has happened. So such a huge proportion exercise is undertaken, then how would it be put into effect and how would it work? There are huge concerns here. Then on Sundays also in Hindu, you have science and technology coverage. So here the first news is biomarkers for glioma brain tumor found in peripheral blood. So researchers have found potential gene biomarker then can be used for prognosis and early diagnosis of most aggressive form of primary brain tumor called glioblastoma. So the biomarkers can help in knowing if the tumor is in initial stage or advanced stage. So this is a multi-institutional research work. which has found how early diagnosis is possible through biomarkers. So you should understand what are biomarkers. These are gene biomarkers. They are specific locations or specific traits which are seen. So a patient's tissue sample is taken, and through it the biomarkers are understood. And then here you have need for a different approach to address child malnutrition. The child malnutrition is declining in the country, but it is said the rate of decrease is very slow. So what steps, what interventions need to be undertaken to ensure and to tackle child malnutrition is detailed out here, you can see. So different strategies you can see is mentioned here. Like the targeted approach is required in areas with highest overall burden and worst wealth disparities. So it is child malnutrition is also linked to income. Already government has initiated national nutrition mission. So that is also addressing child malnutrition. And this is shape of sun's corona accurately predicted. So the advanced prediction gives a large window of preparedness for space weather variations. So these are solar physicists from Center for Excellence in Space Sciences in Kolkata. They have succeeded in predicting the shape of sun's corona at the time of the annular eclipse on December 25. So the corona, you should understand, it's the outermost part of the sun's atmosphere. So this is the second successful prediction. So here you can see, it is showing the shape of the sun's corona. So this affects the weather events. So this helps in understanding space weather variations too. Then on Sundays, you also have dispatches coverage in which important international news from across the world are covered. So here the first one is on Brazil. So there are allegations of corruption and militia links against the president's son. So here you can see the president of Brazil, Jair Bolsonaro. So he is facing embarrassment now because his sons are indicted in allegations of corruption and militia links. So even his allies are turning away from him now. And this is Putin's double bet: train to Crimea and gas to Ukraine. So Russia has inked a gas deal with Ukraine while deepening its influence in the annexed Crimea. So Crimea is a part of Ukraine, you can say, which has been annexed by Russia, and now Russia is having a train to Crimea, integrating it further with its territory, and having a gas deal with Ukraine too. So this is Russian strategy discussed here, and this is ensuring memories don't die. So this is regarding a museum in Sri Lanka showing its troubled past. And this is road to uncertainty. So this is regarding Afghan elections. The presidential elections have been held and early results have been announced, but there's no consensus on the winner yet. So regarding Afghan presidential elections. So this you don't need to go in detail. Even this is fine. If you know Sri Lankan history of LTT, this is an important issue. Crimea and Ukraine issue. This is important. So this one news is very important here. So that is it. Then the last page has sports related news, which is not important for civil services. So that is it. Thank you.